I praise and thank God for this beautiful morning time that God has given us to come in His presence once again, to spend some time meditating upon His miracles that He performed while He was here on this earth. For our meditation, let's turn to the Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 15, verses 22 to 28. And behold, a woman of Canaan came out of the same coast and cried unto him, saying, Have mercy on me, O Lord, thou son of David, my daughter is grievously vexed with the devil. But he answered her not a word, and his disciples came and besought him, saying, Send her away, for she crieth after us. But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Then came she and worshipped him, saying, Lord, help me. But he answered and said, It is not meet to take the children's bread and to cast it to dogs. And she said, Truth, Lord, yet the dogs eat of the crumbs which fall from their master's table. Then Jesus answered and said unto her, O woman, great is thy faith, be it unto thee even as thou wilt. And her daughter was made whole from that very hour. This incident, which is very much familiar to us, teaches how faith emerges victorious after confronting many discouragements. This is the victory of importunity of a Canaanite woman. According to the Jews, she belonged to the most hated among the Gentile race. And so, when she came to the Lord with her petition, the disciples must have tried to get rid of her at the earliest, and none might have encouraged or supported her plea. Lord Jesus also ignored her plea without uttering a word. And out of frustration, the disciples brought her case before the Lord so that He Himself may send her away. This is the first time our Savior ministering to a Gentile. And look at the way how He dealt with her. At first, He neglected her. And then when she came begging for her daughter's deliverance, instead of comforting her, His words were still harder and harsher than before. Well, look at the attitude of this woman. There is much that we need to learn from her faith, which our Lord appreciated. She did not come to Lord Jesus just for her healing. She accepted Jesus as her Lord. She knew for sure that the Son of David is not only the Lord of the children of Israel, but He is the Lord of the Gentiles also, the people whom she belonged to. But when Jesus said that He has come for the lost sheep of Israel, she did not lose hope. It is written that she worshipped Him and again pleaded, Lord, help me. She did not use the word Lord just for name's sake. She actually means it, and it can be seen in her words again. When Lord Jesus indirectly categorized her as a dog, her determined words tells that He is still her Lord. And she humbly and gladly accepted the position which her Lord gave her. The ones who claimed themselves as the children of God and were waiting for the Messiah were not ready to accept the Lordship of the Savior. They needed the healings and the blessings of the Lord, but to accept Jesus as their Master was difficult for them, because it was difficult for them to humble themselves before the Lord. But the woman humbled herself, and that helped her to cling on to Him more firmly, as He is the only ray of hope to her in this dark world. Look at the great faith she had. She knows the Lord is an all-sufficient Lord, and He has enough to spare to feed the dogs also. When the children of Abraham, who were called to be a blessing for the world, want to confine the blessings within themselves, here a person claims to be a part of that blessing, as if she knew the heart of the Lord, that He has come to bless the whole world. The spiritual heavenly blessings are for everyone. The sense of her want urged her to plead to the Lord in prayer, and she emerged victorious at the end. Remember, before the Lord appreciates our faith, it will be tested to its fullest. It will have to face all discouragements. But if you really trust the Lord, your faith will come out as refined silver that is precious in the eyes of the Lord. And above all, do we rejoice when others share the blessings of our Father? Do we have the faith that He is an omnipotent, merciful God who has bountiful blessings for everyone who approaches Him? The faith of that woman claimed that she too belongs to the household of the Lord and His blessings belong to her also. And she received the blessing for which she approached the Lord, and this happened before the eyes of the chosen nation, who are the descendants of the Father of faith. Dear brothers and sisters, let our faith be rooted in our relationship with Him. If He is our Lord, let us humble ourselves and cling to Him for our survival. And may the Lord help us for that. Shall we close our eyes and bow our head and pray? Father, we praise You and thank You for this beautiful opportunity that You have given us. Thank You for showing us that our faith will be tested. And Lord, help us to humble ourselves. Help us to have that attitude that this Canaanite woman had. Thank You, Lord, for teaching us. Help us to be humble. May Your name be glorified. In Jesus' most holy name we pray. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, the coming of the Lord is so near. The Lord has been helping us to look at each miracle that the Lord has performed. And we are learning so many things. And may the Lord help us to be spiritually enriched and be a blessing for many. May God bless each one of us. Our Lord is coming very soon. Maranatha.